What's happening, everybody? Trey here, and today at Reactions to the Classics, it is time for a reaction to Queens of the Stone Age and their song from their really highly acclaimed album, Songs for the Deaf. Well, we got the song, Song for the Dead, and I want to shout out our longtime patron and friend of the channel and a pretty big Queens of the Stone Age fan, Ryan, for suggesting this for a reaction today. Ryan suggested a couple of their songs, their live performances for the live streams that we do every Friday over at Twitch, so be sure to give us a follow there. Always a good time hanging out, talking music. Ryan had this to say about the track. This is from their biggest album, Songs for the Deaf, which is a loose concept album, taking the listener on a journey through the Californian desert and using the radio as a tool to make fun of mainstream music, but is also used as a metaphor to face your own issues, which is something the protagonist on the album clearly cannot do. He is constantly changing the radio and only listening to what he wants to hear. Oh, I'm already intrigued. Ryan also says this is easily one of the most badass songs I've ever heard. It features Screaming Trees, Mark Lanegan's grunge-inspired voice. We also have Dave Grohl absolutely destroying the drum kit. I'm looking forward to this one, man. I mean, I've heard a lot of great things, of course, about Queens of the Stone Age, but I haven't listened to an album in full yet, and you know, this is probably one of the biggest records from this century that I still need to listen to. So this will be a good introduction, man. As always, gonna have the lyrics pulled up, gonna just listen, take in, and enjoy the track, then give my thoughts afterwards. So thank you again to Ryan. Let's get it. I already tell this thing gonna be a heavy hitter, ladies and gentlemen. Bro already hitting those fills like crazy, man. Really loving this arrangement. Ooh. Got an ominous feel to this song, y'all. I'm really digging it. I think those backing ahs just give it a bigger, just a ominous, dark feeling to it, man. Josh about to shred for us. Thank you. And just, you can feel the power and anger in Grohl's drumming performance here, man. Oh, let's go, man. Take it up to 11. If this ain't getting you fired up, I don't know what will. Let's go, Dave. Wow, Song for the Dead, Queens of the Stone Age, absolutely murdering this, man. Started almost with like a 10-second, sounded like an organ, which already kind of set the dark atmosphere. And then we got Josh Homme's like, you know, it was kind of a bit of a, you know, just short and sweet riff, man. Sweet's probably the wrong word, because it just carried, yet again, that a bit of that aggression in the riff, almost like it was revving up. And then you got Mark's vocals coming in, which seemed to just blend perfectly with this musical arrangement, with that, you know, yet again, kind of a bit of that ominous, dark nature to it. And I thought that he delivered a hell of a vocal performance, man. Lyrically, we start, "It's late enough to go driving and see what's mine. Life's the study of dying, how to do it right. You're a holy roller if you betting to lose. If you're hanging around, I'm holding the noose." I mean, that right there just conjures up those images, man, of a guy you don't want to mess with, and a guy who might be you know, a little off up there, man. And then we further that saying there's a hearse rolling over, just a track in the line. And then I think yet again, that atmosphere and arrangement was just heightened by Josh's just backing vocals, man. And then the highlight for me on this song, for as good as Josh's guitar work was and Mark's lead vocals, Grohl's drum fills here were fantastic. And then those last couple minutes were really a showcase for Grohl. You could just feel that aggression, the power, the passion through the drum kit there that Dave was bringing forth, hitting those things so hard, man. You couldn't help but get a little bit fired up, man. Get your blood racing a bit. And man, I was very impressed with this track, and I think a lot of people are too. So as I was reading a little bit, 2014 Ultimate Guitar users voted this the best Queens of the Stone Age song in their discography. So you know, that's going to tell you something right there for you know, how many acclaimed records and songs these guys have. The fans love it, and I can freaking see why, man. Ryan, you were right. Badass, great word to describe this song. And man, one that I gotta hit the heart on Spotify, that's for sure. Just really dug everything about this, man. I gotta check out this album sooner rather than later. And let me know, y'all, what you thought of this track down in the comment section below. Any other Queens of the Stone Age's song I need to check out? And be sure to give Ryan some love as well for suggesting this and bringing it to RTTC today. If you like the video, be sure to give it a thumbs up. Hit that big red subscribe, making that push to 15K, almost there. Appreciate all of y'all. And until next time, thanks for watching, happy listening, and I will see you.